Wait. the Santa Maria. The Santa Maria being the best looking of the three. Lots of gold and carved wood. Even the Pinta had its admirers. But it was the Nina that Christopher was fondest of, for it was named after his mother, Nina Columbus.
Go ahead, play Columbus, stop baby, stop making me crazy, Marvin, crazy Marvin. I love the way Marvin acts. I do. Do not make me sad and do not undo the facts. Relax, 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 relax.
Go ahead, play Columbus, stop baby, stop making me crazy.
Columbus's trip to America was his secret girlfriend.
A historical fact.
He was her date at a cotillion given by Spanish high society on the occasion of her inauguration. But because he wasn't royalty, he was forced to stay upstairs in her bedroom. And while she cavorted downstairs, he read back issues of Stella Doro and other 15th century periodicals.
Columbus.
It was one of the best nights of my life.
He loves his goldberg.
She kissed me in her play. She gave me words to say. Made me what I am.
That's why.
Tuesday, did I pick my laundry up Wednesday night?
Yes, I do. Yes, I do.
Do you take this man to be your
I do.
thinks I'm rude, but nice. I think he's nice, but indiscreet. He thinks I'm sweet, but he treats me kind of funny, I say.
Going down.
Exactly.
This is what happened. One day, now this is the truth. One day, outside Poma del Fuego, he necked furiously with a man whose red hair and broad shoulders reminded Columbus of his mother. Columbus had never felt such a deep surge of emotion beneath his Italian marble facade. They met at odd hours, off and on, for 3 weeks, Columbus and this gentleman from Poma del Fuego.
And soon Isabella, who was no dummy, realized that Columbus was having an affair with someone else.
And Columbus had hell to pay. Yes, sir, I mean hell.
He was half out of his mind with grief over Isabella's anger. Well, because Isabella paid for his fine clothes, she provided him with a fine apartment, rent-free.
And he loved her.
You're telling me he grieved because he loved
I'm
her?
I'm telling you the
truth. Shut up. The lady wanted him out of her life, and she always got what she wanted. She swore that he would never have another woman as long as he lived. So, she put him on a doomed boat with known homosexuals and laughed a royal wicked laugh.
Like this.
Those who knew him well say Columbus was half out of his mind by the time they strapped him to that ship and pushed him out to sea.
On board, Columbus stayed in his room and sulked. He spoke to no one except the porter. He told his porter that if they came across any new land, it was to be called Isabella, in hopes that the queen would forgive him.
He wrote her love letters, begging her forgiveness. He wrote,
"Dear Isabella, forgive me."
You think she was moved? You think so? Well, then you didn't know Isabella. She laughed in his face.
Like this.
He wrote her.
"Dear Isabella, you don't know the whole story. I was not having an affair with a lady in waiting."
He would send the letters by carrier pigeon.
He wrote.
"Dearest Isabella."
She laughed in his face.
He wrote her.
"If I should discover any new land, I shall name it Isabella Land."
Until one day,
there came a knock at the door
of Columbus's room.
On board this ship.
On which Queen Isabella.
Royalty of Spain.
I imported her captain,
Christopher Columbus.
"Please come in."
Columbus could not believe his eyes.
Columbus could not trust his legs.
There, outlined by the light of the sea, stood the handsome young man from Poma del Fuego.
"Please, come in."
The young man asked if he could sit down. He asked if there was anything to drink. He asked if he could take off his clothes.
They got into bed.
Where they didn't sleep.
"Well, we slept a little."
"For 30 days.
50 days!
85 rapturous days and nights."
When Marvin suggested...
"Not a moment too soon!"
"That they should take a shower. But thank God they did."
All of this, Columbus wrote in a letter to Isabella.
To tell you the truth, she wasn't interested. She ripped the letter up. She said that she was disgusted and appalled, and she said to her husband that, well, as far as she was concerned, Columbus was one dead explorer.
The two bachelors left Columbus's room, arm in arm, bound for the shower, and were halted by a magnificent landmass ahead. Everybody was yelling, "There's Isabella Land!"
Because that was the name I had told the porter to give any new land we came across.
"There's Isabella Land!"
It was a bright green land.
A ballsy land.
A land brimming with possibilities.
"Men,"
he said.
He spoke to the assembled homosexuals.
He was very moved by this discovery.
"No longer do I call this fine green land Isabella Land. Rather, this land I see before me today, I name America, after Amerigo Vespucci, a young man I met in Poma del Fuego, with red hair and broad shoulders, like my mother."
Thank you.
sat around and said they'd never lose their love, and that they lost their love. 5 foot men trousers banged the table where they found their voice. It was a lyric's choice, but it sat in your and whistled through their teeth. They gave directions underneath, on legs and knees, these four young ladies sat around and said they'd never lose.
Crying in trousers, people living in trousers, people screwing in trousers, 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 in trousers